Hi viewer, welcome to Edin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through geography form 1, lesson 2. The topic, it is still introduction to geography. That is where we are continuing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the branches of geography. And then also other terms that are in geography. We start by looking at other terms that are used in geography. And we are going to look at the first one, which is the habitat. When we talk about the habitat, it is the home that provides the physical condition under which a certain plant and animal live. So when you look at many plants and animals, they survive in different situations, in different conditions. For example, there are those that can survive, that can do well in arid and semi-arid areas. There are others that can do well in tropical areas. So those are the ones that we refer to them as the habitat. There are others that can do well in grassland and others that can do well in forest. So those are what we refer to them as the habitat. Then we also have the ecology. It is the next term after defining the term habitat. Ecology, it is all the set of external conditions. So when we put all the sets, all the information, all the habitat, we took it and then put it in one set, we refer to it as the ecology. For example, when I talk about the semi-desert, all those conditions, starting the climate, going to the vegetation that are found there, they affect or they influence the animal that is going to live in those areas. Even the human being who live in those arid areas, they will behave in different ways than the ones who live in areas where we have the climate being hot. And the areas where we have cold climates, those they have totally different behaviors. So that is the reason as to why we are supposed to look at the ecology. We say that it is all set of external conditions surrounding that it will influence and develop a certain organism to have a specific behavior. Then we look at the branches of geography. There are three branches of geography. We have the first one, that is the physical geography. Then we have the human geography, and then the practical geography. We start by looking at the physical geography. We see that physical geography, it is mainly concerned with the land forming processes. These are the processes that will influence the shapes the surface of the earth will take, and also the features that are found on the earth surface. So that is the reason as to why we refer to them as the physical. It involves all, even the study of weather and climate. And all these is tested. All the work that is done in physical geography, it is tested in the geography paper 1. That is in Kenya Certificate of the Secondary Education, Geography Paper 1. And its main areas, we have already identified them. We have the internal land forming processes, external land forming processes. We also have soils and vegetation. We also have the weather and climate. Then the earth and the solar system. Then we look at the next one, that is the human geography. So when we talk about the human geography, this involves the study of the human activities on the earth surface. Remember, we said geography, it involves the physical and also the human activities and how they have influence. So that is the reason as to why we can have the second branch, that is the human geography. It is covered in the geography paper 2. That is in Kenya Certificate, Secondary Education. Then this is what it entails, the elements. We have the cultural, we also have the population, we also have the political bit, economic and urban. So when you look at the things where GNT is, you can be able to see that they are found in those categories. We have the forestry, we also have the wildlife, tourism, fishing, mining, energy industries, population and urbanization. We also have trade, transport and communication. We also have the agriculture and management and conservation. All that is what is covered in geography paper 2. Then we have the practical geography. This is the practical aspect of geography. And if at all you look at the practical geography, it is inculcated in the two branches. And this one now it assists the student to understand and interpret geographical information. And it also helps the learner to get clear what he is taught in class. Physical geography includes the map work. We also have the photograph work, field study, and statistics. The activity for today's lesson, we have the explain the three branches of geography. Then the reference book, it is still KLB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 1, that edition. For more information, you can get us from the details that is found there. You can SMS, you can also get us through the YouTube, Facebook, and the Twitter. So that is where you can get us. Stay tuned to LinkTV. Thank you.